Hey everybody, Adam Savage here in my cave with a show and tell, and a little bit of, it's a little mathematics. No, not math, more like geometry. Maybe not like okay. Hi, Adam Savage here in my cave with a show and tell, and I'm gonna begin my show and tell by talking about this strip of paper. I have a medium weight strip of paper here, and I think we can all agree that it has two sides and four edges. One, two, three, four. I recognize that like dimensionally it is thin, but we can still imagine that this is an edge. It's not an infinitely narrow plane. It is a dimensional one. Okay, I'm going to turn this into a shape that has only one side and one edge. Many of you have probably seen this demo before, but I remember when my dad did it for me when I was a kid. And in order to take this two-sided piece of paper, this geometrical construction, and give it one side and one edge, we need to join it in a loop, but turn it one half turn in that loop. And this is how we create that magic. So I'm going to turn it, I've turned it one half loop, one half turn, and I'm adding a second piece of tape over here. And what I have made is called a Mobius strip, M-O-B-E-U-S, Mobius, named after the mathematician, I believe. Forgive me if I'm wrong, I am not number file, but this Mobius strip has one side and one edge. And here is how we can confirm that. If I take this magic marker and I start drawing a line and I don't lift my magic marker and I just keep on drawing this line, so I am not lifting it from this piece of paper. I am not lifting it. I am simply dragging the piece of paper underneath it. I think you can start to see what's happening here. As I do this, I'm going to end up meeting the other side of the line. And here it is. I've met the other side of the line. So I've drawn a line that connects to itself without lifting it off the paper. That is only one side. And if I did the same thing with the edge, you would see the same thing. I'm not going to in this video. You can do it yourself. It has one side and one edge. Now, there is a specific and awesome subset of glass blowing that delves into this kind of mathematics. And it is a bottle that drifts into the fourth dimension. And it is called a Klein bottle. And I happen to possess one here. And this is... It's a beautiful thing. So the Klein bottle has only one surface because, well, if you wanted to take the magic marker and start to draw on this surface, you would notice that you can draw on the inside and the outside continuously if you allow that right here where the bottle's neck crosses through itself, there's a little fourth dimensional, like, malarkey, but this is a Klein bottle and it has only one surface to it. This one is actually made by one of my heroes, and it's worth talking about the person that made this because his name is Cliff Stoll. He's an astrophysicist and a teacher, if I remember correctly. Clifford Stoll was working at Cal in the 80s when he noticed on the computer system, this is the 80s, the computers connecting to each other via phone lines from around the world was brand spanking new. It was only a few years old. And Cliff was working on the computers there and noticed a discrepancy and ended up teasing out that discrepancy and finding that there was an actual KGB hacker trying to break into American military systems using the university computer system, and he was stealing passwords. It is an amazing case, and it was Clifford Stoll ended up writing it into a book called The Cuckoo's Egg, which is a wonderful and delightful read. It is about his going for his PhD at the same time as he went through basically trying to educate the FBI and anyone who would listen that this 50-cent discrepancy in the computer logs might actually mean something much more important that everyone should pay attention to. And effectively, sort of the very first documented case of ferreting out a hacker. I'm sure there are earlier excursions, but this one is super famous. It was also made into a Nova documentary, which is just as delightful to watch as Clifford Stoll's book is to read. Clifford is a technology skeptic, and when you read his arguments about being skeptical about what technology has done for us in terms of social media and global outreach, etc., his skepticism is firmly based in reason. I might run my life differently than Cliff does, but I totally agree, understand and agree with most of his arguments about how dubious he is about technology. So I was really familiar with Clifford Stoll in my late teens. I read The Cuckoo's Egg at like 19 or 20 years old. And then I saw the Nova documentary in the late 80s. And then I found out he was making Klein bottles. And then Brady Heron from Numberphile came by here. And he had just come from Cliff's studio, and Cliff sent this over to me. We still have a grand, unrealized plan to get together. We're mutual fans. But the glass blowing of Klein bottles, this is about it, the simplest thing there is. And people make these in all sorts of different sizes. But there are also Klein bottles that are nested inside of Klein bottles that are nested inside of Klein bottles. There is sort of no end to the rabbit hole when you start to investigate making fourth dimensional glass blown objects. And I, as somebody who has cobbled together several different careers across multiple different industries over the course of my life, I really enjoy Clifford Stoll's life story because it does the same across a vastly different set of realities than I have been exposed to. And yet, you know, in his book, he details this beautiful defense of his PhD thesis. And if I remember correctly, in his defense, they just asked him why the sky was blue, and he answered, and they kept on asking for hours and hours and hours until he was talking about it on a quantum level, I must assume. And that has stuck with me. Like, I haven't read that book a second time, but in my late teens, that excursion really stuck with me. And to find out that he's glass blowing Klein bottles just makes me super happy. You never, never know where you're going to end up. And by the way, if you're at all curious about Mobius strips, there's all sorts of fun things you can do with them by cutting them in half, by adding twists and keeping on cutting. There's some really remarkable things that happen to shapes when you do that. I am not sure about the public's ability to obtain a Clifford Stoll Klein bottle, but if there is a website, we will link to it in the comments below. Clifford Stoll, you are one of my heroes, and I say hello and thank you for this from across the ether of the internet, and hope we can get together soon. This has been Adam Savage here in my cave, and Fourth Dimensional Bottle is today's show and tell. I'll see you next time.